Throughout the 20th century, women strived to break barriers and gain more rights. The World Wars exposed women to the world outside the home and changed their perspectives on their roles in society. Several civil rights laws aided women in fulfilling their quest for equality in voting rights, employment, and wages. One key component lacking was equity in education. Before the 1970s, women were stereotyped as homemakers. They were discouraged from pursuing education and professional careers. Title IX filled a gap in the civil rights legislation as women realized that empowerment needs education. Women who are entering the workforce in record numbers faced a persistent earnings gap compared to their male counterparts. As a consequence of the equality in workforce debate, Americans also began to focus attention generally on inequities that inhibited the progress of women and girls in education. Several advocacy groups filed class action lawsuits against colleges and universities and the federal government. These advocacy organizations complained of an industry-wide pattern of sex bias against women who worked in colleges and universities.
Mink and Representative Edith Green co-authored Title IX of the Education Amendments of 1972. Title IX established equal opportunity for women in graduate school admissions, financial aid, and athletic programs.
She remembered her times in graduate school where she was the only woman in the class, only one of the handful of women in the whole school. And to her, that just wasn't acceptable.
On June 23, 1972, President Nixon signed Title IX into law.
Title IX was a broad language covering everything and not touching anything specifically. It basically said in a very few words, you shall not discriminate in our educational institutions on the basis of sex. Pure and simple. It didn't mention sports, it didn't mention social studies, home economics, or anything else. You just couldn't discriminate in our educational system.
Title IX was a catalyst that led to a social revolution. Education is the passport for opportunity in life. So by mandating equal educational opportunities, Title IX ensured a brighter future for more Americans.
Title IX sailed through Congress, but controversy soon erupted. Before Title IX, 98% of college athletic budgets went to men's teams. But the new law required schools to provide opportunities for female athletes, leaving less money for men.
If we're asked to reduce expenditures in football drastically, then we'll fall out of the big time, we'll fall out of the Big Ten competitive structure, and we won't generate all those revenues. So the goose that laid the golden egg will be killed.
For 3 years, men's coaches lobbied to exempt college sports from Title IX.
Title IX challenged entrenched social values. As a result, it caused intense reactions. Over the decades, reactions have progressed from opposition to tolerance to gradual acceptance. In the 40 years since Title IX was passed, the educational landscape of the United States has changed. More women are pursuing higher education, participating in sports, and receiving legal protection against sexual harassment. By not excluding half the population, Title IX causes social reform by sending a message to the current generation of girls that their future is limitless. The amount of women going to college has almost doubled since 1970. Additionally, interest in women in STEM has increased. However, a gap still exists between this interest and career choice. But thanks to Title IX and STEM promotions from organizations, this divide is closing. On the field like in the classroom, Title IX gave women access to the benefits of playing sports, such as leadership and perseverance.
If you let me play.
You let me play sports.
I will like myself more.
I'll have more self-confidence.
If you let me play sports.
If you let me play.
If you let me play.
I will be 60% less likely to get breast cancer.
I will suffer less depression.
If you let me play sports.
I will be more likely to leave a man.
If you let me play.
I'll be less likely to get pregnant before I want to.
I will learn.
I will learn what it means to be strong.
To be strong.
If you let me play.
Play sports.
If you let me play sports.
Over time, the perception of a woman's role in society has changed due to the reforms created by Title IX. Participation in team sports and new educational paths and careers expanded the traditional role of a woman in society.
What will the next 30 years bring? Will female athletes in high school and college overtake their male counterparts in participation opportunities and in scholarship dollars? 30 years after the passage of Title IX, women still face tremendous hurdles in the area of sports administration. Fewer than 44% of coaches of women's teams are women, and fewer than 2% of coaches of men's teams are women. Will women attain parity? Or will the critics of Title IX erode the hard-fought gains that women have realized?
History has shown that social change takes time. It is wishful thinking that Title IX will achieve its goals and not be needed a few years from now. Title IX forced Americans to confront inequalities that women face in educational opportunities. While the inequalities might have reduced slowly without it, Title IX brought about changes at a faster pace that made some people uncomfortable. By making it a federal law, the United States sent a strong message that gender discrimination in education will not be tolerated. Now girls can dream big and have the same opportunities as boys to reach their potentials. Because of Title IX, there are many more athletes, lawyers, and engineers today than ever before. Women bring different views, perspectives, and talents. By having both men and women in key decision-making roles in our society, America has become economically smarter.